had the famous Never Trump cover, National Review. I remember Jack Fowler giving that to me. That certainly made you all big fans, a big hit with all of your subscribers, 100% of them, or maybe not. But where do you stand a year later? How do you sort through, let's say, a pretty significant tax cut with a president that preaches moral equivalency for neo-Nazis? How do you sort through a Neil Gorsuch nomination with behavior that even Neil Gorsuch was offended by when he questioned the independent judiciary? How do you do it? How does National Review do it? How do conservatives and Republicans do it moving forward?
Well, I've been wrong about two things with this president. One, I thought we'd see really unorthodox policy and an unorthodox approach to the agenda, whereas it's been an utterly conventional Republican agenda with some exceptions. And on some things like energy, deregulation, judges, we really have seen like an A-plus agenda. So that's been a very pleasant surprise.
Let's just be clear here. Again, ideologically, for conservatives, this is what conservatives have wanted when it came to tax policy, regulatory policy, and judges. And those are basically the top three issues anyway.
Correct.
Right.
But I also think or thought he would do more to moderate his behavior or at least not make his character flaws so evident, whereas he uses Twitter basically to advertise his resentments and vindictiveness.
And craziness.
And going back to what you were, I think you read something from Andrew Sullivan at the top of the show, we have this bizarre disconnect where we have this poisonous froth of our politics. On one hand, because Trump just stirs the pot all the time. One, because he can't help himself. Two, because he actually enjoys it to a certain extent. And then you have this hysterical reaction to him when actually the underlying condition, material condition of the country is quite good, arguably as good as it's been for 10 years.
Right.
No major foreign wars. The economy is growing, and it's been growing for a long time, but now it's growing in a way. We had these stories from the Wall Street
Crime at record lows.
Yep.
And even though he wants to build a wall, the immigration flow has actually been a net negative over the past 5 years. Wages better than they've been in 25 years. Consumer confidence better than they've been in 25 years. And yet, right track, wrong track is 80-20 going the wrong way.
So if he just sat in his pajamas and had his executive time and watched as much cable TV as he wanted to and throws his remote at it every time he sees something he doesn't like and then otherwise just didn't tweet and showed up and read his lines, he'd probably have about a 47% approval rating.
I agree.
I wouldn't be at 50. I'm not sure whether anyone will ever really be at 50 in a sustained way for a very long time to come.
I agree. He gets in his way. And I've got to say, I think your two surprises, or the two main surprises Meek and I have had knowing this guy for a decade, he's a lifelong Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
And he used to always joke, "Stop calling me a Democrat." I said, "You're a Democrat." And so I was sure conservatives were going to be disappointed. I was shocked by how ideologically conservative he was. And secondly, I did think, and Mika did think, and he did say in real time during the campaign that he was going to moderate after winning the nomination. Right. He has not moderated a bit.
I would add a third surprise. If you told me at the beginning of 2018 he'd have a fairly warm working relationship with Paul Ryan and Mitch McConnell, and Steve Bannon would be on the outside as a smoldering ruin, I never would have believed that.
So the things that are going well that you all mentioned here, aside from the judicial nominations, Gorsuch, what of that list is Trump actually responsible for?
I mean, not a lot.
That's what I was. I just wanted to make.
And I think.